Dear students, today I am going to discuss about zero divisors of a ring. Zero divisors of a ring. A non-zero element of a ring is said to be zero divisor or divisor of zero. Divisor of zero. If there exists an element B not equal to zero, such that their product, that means AB equal to zero, either AB equal to zero or BI is equal to zero. So again, a non-zero element of a ring R is said to be a zero divisor or divisor of a zero. If there exists an element B not equal to zero, it is again non-zero element, such that its product AB equal to zero or B equal to zero. That means if there exists a two non-zero elements in R, that implies their product must be equal to zero. That AB R equal to 0, AB equal to 0 or BI equal to 0. If there exists a two non-zero elements of a ring R, that means A not equal to 0, B not equal to 0, implies its products must be equal to 0, then we say that A is a divisor of 0 and B is also divisor of 0. These two are non-zero elements, but its product must be equal to 0, then we say that A or B, and those two, A and B, are said to be zero divisors of a ring R. I give an example to zero divisors of a ring. From group theory, we have a group Z6. This set of integers addition modulo 6. The numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The operations are, is ring with respect to, the operations are addition modulo 6 and multiplication modulo 6. So Z6 is a ring with respect to the operations addition modulo 6 and multiplication modulo 6. In this ring, we have zero divisors. First, to explain about the operations addition modulo 6 and multiplication modulo 6. You have already learnt in group theory, but I will again explain about addition modulo 6 and multiplication modulo 6. If we take any two elements in R, A applying to addition modulo 6 to these two numbers, A addition modulo 6 B is equal to, we get in a remainder R when we divide, we add A and B and divide with 6. That is a remainder. When we add A plus B and divide with 6, we get a remainder R. That is the resulting element of the elements A addition modulo 6 B. Similarly, A multiplication modulo 6 B is also a remainder when we multiply A and B and divide with 6. We get some remainder. That is the resulting element of the A multiplication modulo 6 B. So here we take 2 comma 3 is belongs to Z6, which these two are not equal to 0. Here 2 not equal to 0 and 3 not equal to 0, but its product with respect to multiplication modulo 6 is 0. See that 2 multiplication modulo 6, 3 is equal to, we're applying the definition, 2 into 3 is 6. 6 divided with 6 divided by 6, we get remainder 0. So 2 not equal to 0, 3 not equal to 0, but its product is equal to 0. So 2 comma 3 are the 0 divisors of ring Z6. In the same manner, 4 multiplication modulo 6, 3 is 4 into 3, 12. 12 divided by 6. What is remainder? Yeah, 0. 4 into 3 is 12 divided by 6. We get remainder 0. So the resulting element of 4 multiplication modulo 6, 3. So 4 is non-zero element and 3 is also non-zero element, but its product is equal to 0. Therefore, 2 comma 3 comma 4 are 0 divisors of ring Z6. Therefore, the ring Z6 has 0 divisors. The ring Z6 has 0 divisors. Now, we see the next definition. Rings without 0 divisors. First we learn 0 divisors of a ring. Now, rings without 0 divisors. Rings without 0 divisors. This is an opposite of the 0 divisors. Has 0 divisors, without 0 divisors. Ring with 0 divisors, this is without 0 divisors. So here 2 non-zero elements, its product must be equal to 0. In this definition, if we have this product of 2 elements is equal to 0, then one of these must be equal to 0. In a ring R, if no 2 non-zero elements, of ring, if product of, product of no 2 non-zero elements of R is 0. That means, we have, if AB equal to 0 implies A equal to 0 or B equal to 0. Here, if R is with 0 divisors, there exists a 2 non-zero elements, their product must be equal to 0. R has without 0 divisors, R has no 0 divisors, is that if the product AB equal to 0 implies A equal to 0 or B equal to 0. Here, I give one example to ring without 0 divisors. We know that this set of integers, real numbers, all the numbers not satisfying this condition, but here this set Z is the set of integers. If we take any two numbers product AB equal to 0, then in these two numbers any one of these must be equal to 0. usual multiplication. We know that in usual multiplication, the product of two numbers is equal to zero. Then one of these must be equal to zero. Or be equal to zero. For example, 0 into 2 is equal to 0. 0 into 4 is equal to 0. Or 10 into 0 is equal to 0. So one of these two elements must be equal to 0. So R has no 0 divisors. Z has no 0 divisors. So this is the definition for the zero divisors of a ring. This is for the rings without zero divisors. Therefore, this set of integers has no zero divisors, but Z6 has zero divisors. So we know that the number systems, natural numbers, real numbers, integers, these are all the rings has no zero divisors. Now we see the definition of a cancellation laws in a ring. That is, already we used cancellation laws in rings, but we are mentioned the cancellation laws in a ring. The cancellation laws laws in a ring. If R is a ring, then R is a group with respect to addition. By definition of a ring, R plus is abelian group. And second condition, R dot semi group. Third one, distributive laws hold. That means R is a group with respect to addition. This is a abelian group with respect to addition. From group theory, we have the cancellation laws hold in groups. So the cancellation laws hold in R plus. That means the cancellation laws with respect to addition satisfying in all rings. So the cancellation laws satisfying in all rings with respect to the addition only. So the question of cancellation laws holding in a ring arises only for the composition multiplication. So now see the definition of a cancellation laws is ring. In a ring R, if A, B, C belongs to R and A not equal to 0, AB equal to AC implies B equal to C, and A not equal to 0, BA equal to CA implies B equal to C. See the definition. In a ring R, if we take three elements and A is non-zero element, if AB equal to AC, we have in any problem or theorem, we have AB equal to AC implies we take B equal to C. That means A cancelled. This is a non-zero element of the equation. And A not equal to 0, here BA equal to CA. Here A is right side of the equation on both sides. here A is the left side of the equation on both sides. So this is left cancellation law and this is right cancellation law. These two are called the cancellation laws of a ring R. Already we used with respect to addition the cancellation laws in a ring R. We used with respect to addition, that means a plus, we have a plus b equal to a plus b, a plus c, then we take, we cancel it and we take b equal to c. Similarly here mentioned about with respect to multiplication, those are the cancellation laws in a ring. So this is a definition for the cancellation laws holding in R, tells about the cancellation laws with respect to multiplication. So this is here the binary operation is that multiplication. Therefore the cancellation laws tells about AB equal to AC implies A equal to C, and similarly BA equal to CA implies B equal to C. Next we see the theorem. Theorem statement: if R is a ring with zero divisors without zero divisors, statement is that without zero divisors, if and only if, written as if IFF, that means that if and only if R satisfying cancellation laws, the cancellation laws hold in R, the cancellation laws hold in R. We have another statement for this theorem, that is also we can write R has no zero divisors double implies cancellation laws hold in R, cancellation laws hold in R. Already we learned in group theory, in the statement we have the necessary and sufficient condition and if and only if, double implies, these three are the same meaning. That is, we have to prove this theorem in two parts because the statement has two statements. That is, R, we have to assume, first we have to assume that R has no zero divisors, then we have to prove cancellation laws hold in R. Here bifurcate double implies as implies and reverse implies. That means first we assume that R has no zero divisors, zero divisors implies we prove that cancellation laws hold in R. Second part is that conversely we assume that this part, that means if R satisfying cancellation laws we prove that we have to assume that R satisfying the cancellation laws, we have to prove R has no zero divisors, R has no zero divisors. So we prove this theorem in two parts. First we assume that R has no zero divisors, we have to prove the cancellation laws hold in R. Conversely, we assume that the cancellation laws hold in R, we have to prove that R has no zero divisors. So firstly, first part, we assume that R has no zero divisors. First we assume that R has no zero divisors. I will write again the statement. If R is a ring without zero divisors, double implies the cancellation laws hold in R. Proof. First we assume that ring without zero divisors, that means R has no zero divisors. For the first part, we have to prove that the cancellation laws hold in R. The cancellation laws hold in R. What is the definition of cancellation laws? Already I told that if ABC belongs to R, A not equal to 0, AB equal to AC implies A equal to C, B equal to C, and A not equal to 0, BA is equal to CA implies B equal to C. That means we have to prove the cancellation laws hold in R. We take three elements and a non-zero element and product AB equal to AC. Then we have to prove B equal to C. So let A, B, C belongs to R and A not equal to 0. And also take AB equal to AC. AB equal to AC. AB equal to AC can be written as AB equal to AC taken to right side. AB minus AC is equal to 0. Then here A is common element to the two products. Therefore, take A is common. Then we get A into B minus C is equal to 0. Here, the product of two numbers is equal to 0. A into B minus C is equal to 0. Our assumption that R has no zero divisors. What is mean by R has no zero divisors? Yeah, the definition of ring without zero divisors means that AB, take AB equal to 0 implies A equal to 0 or B equal to 0. That is the condition for the R has no zero divisors. So here we assume that, and that means R has no zero divisors means R satisfying the particular condition. If you take any two elements product is equal to 0, then there must be one of the 0. One of these two elements must be 0. Therefore, here also the product of A into B minus C is equal to 0. Then we take A equal to 0 or B minus C is equal to 0. Since R has no zero divisors, A equal to 0 or b minus c is equal to 0. But in our hypothesis, we take a is a non-zero element. So here a must be non-zero element. Since a not equal to 0, we take only b minus c is equal to 0. By definition of R has no zero divergence, the product in this product, one of these two, one of the element must be equal to 0. But here A is a non-zero element of our hypothesis. So must and should B minus C is equal to 0. That means B is equal to C. So here we take A is a non-zero element and AB equal to AC, we get B equal to 0. So the definition that if A not equal to 0 and AB equal to AC implies B equal to C, then the cancellation law. Similarly, we can prove that right cancellation law also. Therefore, the left cancellation law. Hole in R. Similarly, we can prove that A not equal to 0, BA is equal to CA implies B equal to C. So totally we are satisfying the left cancellation law and right cancellation law. So R satisfies cancellation laws. Then R, the cancellation laws hold in R. Cancellation laws hold in R. Now we have to prove converse part. What is the converse part? We have to assume that R satisfying the cancellation laws. We have to prove that R has no zero divergence. Conversely, we assume that cancellation laws hold in R. We have to prove R has no zero divergence. We have to prove that R has no zero divergence. Here we prove the converse part by in contradiction model. Here we have to prove R has no zero divergence. But I assume that R has zero divergence. If following the hypothesis, we get a contradiction. So, no, our assumption is wrong. So, R has no, accept with the statement, R has no zero divergence. What is contradiction model? You have to prove here, R has no zero divergence. But myself, I have to assume that R has zero divergence. If possible, suppose that R has zero divergence. That is, by definition, you take two non-zero elements, and their product is 0. implies AB equal to 0. So AB can be written, AB is equal to 0 can be written as A into 0. Already we proved first theorem in rings, the basic properties of a ring. In that, first condition is that A into 0 is equal to 0 into A is equal to 0. From that condition, 0 can be replaced with A into 0. Then, here A is the same element on both sides and from left side of the equation. So, here our assumption that the cancellation laws hold in R, that means R satisfying the cancellation laws. What are the cancellation laws? AB equal to AC, we take B equal to C. Here also we have AB equal to A into 0. So we get B equal to 0. But our assumption that A is non-zero element and B is also non-zero element, but we get B equal to 0, which is contradiction to our hypothesis, which is contradiction, that means which is wrong to our hypothesis. Therefore, our, if possible, suppose that R has no zero divisors is a wrong decision. That means our assumption that is wrong. So we accept with R has no zero divisors. Similarly, we can prove that A is equal to 0 also. Therefore, our assumption is that R has zero divisors is wrong. So therefore R has no zero divisors. Dear students, don't confuse to the theorem, because you have to prove this theorem in two parts. So first we assume that R without zero divisors, we prove the cancellation laws hold in R. Conversely, we assume that R satisfying the cancellation laws, we have to prove R without zero divisors.